Hey guys, welcome to another maths tutorial by Eddie the Magic Monk. Today we're going to talk about how to find the area of a triangle when you don't have the perpendicular height. So before you watch this tutorial, you probably should make sure that you have seen all the other trigonometry tutorials, especially the sine rule. And if you have done that, then let's go ahead and find out how to do this. So firstly, let's draw a right angle triangle. Sorry, not a right angle triangle, just a normal triangle. And let's say we have the perpendicular height. So let's say the perpendicular height is h, and the base is the length of this side here. The area is normally half times base times height, and that is when we are given the height, we could do that. But what if we're not given the height? So I'm going to go back to the mathematical proof for the sine rule. If you remember the sine rule, I had three angles, A, B, and C, and I had their opposite sides labeled as little a, little b, and little c, and I have the perpendicular height in the middle here labeled h. Now the formula for the sine ratio is sine theta equals opposite over hypotenuse, opposite over hypotenuse. So let's say I'm dealing with angle C here as theta, and therefore this side h will be opposite and B would be hypotenuse. So I have sine C equals H over B. And I'm gonna rewrite the H as the subject. So H equals sine C times B. And now what I'm gonna do is substitute the expressions that I have from this triangle, which is A, is the same thing as the base, and H is the perpendicular height, which is sine C times B, as we have discovered. I'm going to substitute these into my area of a triangle equation. So the area is half times base, which is A, times H, which is B times sine C. So here is the formula for the area of a triangle expressed using the variables from the sine rule. So in order to find the area of a triangle when you don't have the perpendicular height, is you're going to need two sides. So for example, 10 centimeters and 15 centimeters. And you also need the angle in between. So let's say that's 30 degrees. So you need that in order to find the area of the triangle. So how you would find that is you're gonna use the formula. So area equals, you're gonna label the sides as A, B for the two sides that you have, and C as the angle. So I have half times 10 times 15 times sine 30, and putting that into the calculator. So half times, make sure your calculator says degrees, 10 times 15 times sine 30, close the bracket, and the answer is 37.5. So the answer is 37.5 centimeters squared. So that is how you find the area of a triangle given two sides and the angle in between. Thanks for watching. See you next time.